matter what happens on the field, it's always a big win for local businesses. And NewsWest Terry Daniels has the dollars and cents of opening day this year. Hi, Terry.
Hello, Cherie. And speaking of dollars and cents, that adds up big time. That's what local officials are doing, adding up all the receipts from bars, restaurants, even taxi cabs doing big business here tonight down in front of the Holy Grail, hotels, all that kind of thing. They do know the estimate to the local economy is in the tens of millions of dollars.
Peanuts, souvenirs.
Huge crowds in a good mood, and they're spending money. Check out John Englert's new Reds jacket. He and his wife Amy say they're spending more than in past years because of the Banks project.
Holy Grail, Toby Keith's.
Moreline House, Lager House, yeah.
It's awesome.
They're all great.
Downtown's hopping.
Best thing that's happened in a long time.
And you're spending money.
Spending money.
Lots of money.
It means tens of millions of dollars in economic impact.
Linda Addis heads up the Regional Tourism Network.
It means shopping, dining, overnight stays in hotels. It's anything that happens inside the ballpark. It's the taxes that are paid on that. It's the income that is earned by the people who work in those jobs.
The Holy Grail overflowed, even with more competition.
It's been great. It has helped attract so many more people on a bunch of different levels. I think people are just, they're getting more comfortable with coming into the area.
And at Fountain Square, where the Cafe de Wheels was having a great day.
I lived in L.A. for a number of years, but I think that opening day here is probably more. People just are into their team. I mean, they're into the Dodgers, but they're really into the Reds. It's fantastic.
And it's good for business.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It is good for business.
The only thing now is cleanup.
And keep in mind, even those people cleaning up after this very long opening day are getting paid, and that too adding to the economic impact. Reporting live at the Banks, Terry Daniels, News 5.